Lord, the devil has come to overtake him. But you said, when the spirit of the Lord, I mean, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord will raise up a new standard against it. So Heavenly Father, I pray that you raise your standard, Lord, that you raise up a mighty standard, Lord, that you come in like a flood, Lord, that you come in and overpower all of the schemes of the enemy, Lord. Heavenly Father, I come to you asking that you take this Sunday service, Lord, this assembly of believers, Lord, and you make it a beacon of hope, Lord, that you make this place a place that Jesus, that our Lord and Savior is worshiped, Lord, that you make this place a drawing place for those who want to serve the Lord. And let this place be different than any other place in this community. Let this place be different than any other home, any other place that people come to do anything, Lord. Let this place be a place that your name brings, that your spirit rules, Lord. And that if we raise up your name, Lord, if we raise you up, you will draw them into us, Lord. That we may show him your glorious mercy, that we may show him your glorious love, and that we may change anything and anybody that comes through our vicinity, Lord. Lord, every person who walks past these doors, Lord, touch them, Lord. Touch them in a way that they can't escape. Touch them in a way that they can't ignore it, Lord. Touch them in a way that they can't put it out of their mind, Lord. Touch them in a way that they will wonder what is going on in this building, Lord. And if they don't find you here, Lord, allow them to find them somewhere else, Lord. And if they know you, Lord, then put them in an assembly where they can be fed, Lord. But if they are looking for a home, Lord, send them to us, Lord. Send us people who need to be fed, Lord, because this is a church of sheep being fed, Lord. This is a church where your people are get the bread of life, Lord, which is you, Heavenly Father. I pray that on this first Sunday that we remember the gift of communion. Heavenly Father, that we remember your blood and your sacrifices, that we do it in remembrance of you, Lord. Heavenly Father, let us take communion with a clean mind and a clean heart, Lord, that we may be able to commune with you, Lord, to have fellowship. That's what it means, Lord. Let us fellowship with you, Lord, and let it not end at 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock in this building, Lord. Let us take it out with us to the parts of New Jersey, Lord, to the parts of Philadelphia, to different sections of the city, Lord. Lord, but especially, Lord, let it come against that spirit of violence in this neighborhood, Lord. Let it come against the spirit of wickedness and brutality towards one another. Let it not creep into our hearts, Lord. You said no weapon formed against us shall prosper, Lord. This is a weapon of the enemy, Lord. Send it down. Shut it down, Lord. And raise your spirit up. Raise your spirit up and let us enjoy this Sunday service, Lord. Let us enjoy this Sunday service. I want to pray for Mother Sills, who is suffering from an issue of asthma, Lord. Lord, you formed those lungs. Heavenly Father, you formed all of those tubes and connecting spots and those DNA structures in those cells, Lord. Lord, only you can give true healing, Lord. Only you can touch her lungs. Only you can touch her nostrils. Only you can touch her mouth, Lord. So, Lord, I pray that you do that in the name of Jesus Christ. Not by my will, but your will be done, Lord. But, Lord, you said that you sent your children out to bring healing, Lord. And if someone is sick, have the elders pray for them, Lord. And Heavenly Father, I'm maybe a deacon or just another brother, but I pray for her anyway, Lord. Touch her, Lord. Touch her and bring healing, Lord. Lift her up, Lord. I pray for Sister Sills, who works hard, and she comes in here every Sunday with a smile, Lord. Strengthen her legs, strengthen her body, Lord. Give her the strength to do all the things that she needs to do. Raise children. Bring food into the house. Come to church on Sunday. And she's still ready to help in any way that she can. I thank you for her, Lord. But I ask that, Lord, you bless her, Lord, for that willingness. Bless her for her hard work. Bless her for the fruit of her hands, Lord. Bless her in every way. Bless her mightily, Lord. I pray for Mother Scott, the mother of the church. Heavenly Father, this church would not even exist without her, Lord. Yes, because yes, you yes. blessed her first, yes, Lord. Yes, yes. Heavenly Father, I'm reminded of Mary of the Bible that through her we get the gift of our Savior, Lord.
Yes.
And through our Savior, we all have life and life more abundantly, but it started with Mary. You chose her, Lord. Yes. You chose her just like you chose Mother Scott, and you blessed her and the fruit of her of your work between her and you, Lord. We have our pastor, Lord. I thank you for our pastor who set up this church, House of Job, Lord. Heavenly Father, I thank you for that. Because we have a place to worship, Lord. We have a place to come and magnify your name. Heavenly Father, I pray for the married couple in the back of the church, Lord, who just walked through this through the doors, Lord. Lord, strengthen them. Be their glue, Lord. Be their glue. Let it be that any problem that enter their relationship will be outnumbered, because it'll be him, her, and the Lord. And then it would be you three against any obstacle, any warfare of the enemy, Lord, any snare, any piece of destruction that you set against them, Lord, and that they will become conquerors like their father before them, Lord, and that they will conquer any traps, any snares, Lord, that they will set the enemy to his floor. To the floor, Lord, where he belongs, because he's a serpent and he belongs on his belly, eating dirt, Lord. So put him in his place, Lord. Set him down and raise up the Spirit of God within him. Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Look who just came through the door. Hallelujah. We didn't have something to praise about before. We got something to praise about right now. You know what? Let's just take a minute and love on them. We're so happy.
Thank you.
We see before us the triumph of the Lord. We see before us the triumph of the Lord. Reverend Jesse was scheduled to have back surgery. Did you have it?
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
And his back is messed up in so different way. But like we said earlier, God is our healer. God is our doctor. And he's here today.
That's right.
And you couldn't even, if I didn't tell you, you wouldn't know that anything was wrong.
That's right. Thank you.
And his wife is here.
Yeah.
And she's had ups and downs in her health. And she's here today. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. 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 I'm going to go right back into prayer.
Yes.
Right back. No, we had to acknowledge that, because when the Lord does something for us, see, that's what testimony is. When we pray out to God and he answers our prayers, and we keep it to ourselves, how does it benefit anyone? But yet, the blessing in their lives blesses each and every one of us, because each Sunday we've been praying for you guys. We've been praying for you guys. We've been doing it in the prayer and just speaking out in the newsletter, everything. We've been praying for you. And to see you walk through the door, it just shows that God is with us. And so I thank you, Lord. I thank you for what you've done. I thank you, Lord. Lord, if we didn't have a praise in our heart before, Lord, how dare us not have a praise in our heart now?
Yes.
Heavenly Father, touch Reverend Jesse's back, Lord. Bless him for the surgery that's oncoming. Lord, heal him, Lord. We know that there's a doctor and a woman, nurses, but there is only one that can bring healing, Lord. There is only one that can bring an ease to his pain, Lord. I pray that you touch his back in a way that it would be the way it was when he was in his 20s, Lord. That it would be the way it was when he was in his teens, Lord. Give him strength in his back. Help him stand upright, Lord. Put everything in place, Lord. You are a God of order. Order his back, Lord, into place. Put it back where it's supposed to happen. And we're not waiting for it to happen a week or two now, Lord. We are calling you to start your work right now, Lord, for this is the day that you have made. Heavenly Father, I touch the health of his wife, Reverend Pastor Bridges. Heavenly Father, touch her health, Lord.
Lord,
we know that there are people in the Word of God who did not even have to come in contact with you, Lord, for you to heal them, Lord. And Heavenly Father, you are in each one of us right now. So, Lord, I pray that the healing that is in you, Lord, leaks out of each saint, Lord, and that it will create an atmosphere of healing, Lord, and that everyone that is in this building, everyone that is in this place will feel the anointing, Lord, will feel the healing power of Jesus Christ, Lord. Not just for our sakes, so that those who are outside of these walls who look at us and wonder, why do we praise you, Lord? They will see the healing. They will see the work that you are doing, Lord, in this place, and will want to be a part of what you are doing, Lord. Lord, that's how we bring people to Christ. That's how we show people the way. We show them the work that God is doing in our lives, and we show them mightily with action and with love and compassion, Lord. So give us that love, Lord. Give us that compassion. You said that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And as your children, Lord, we are supposed to carry that love that you have for the world. So allow us to carry that will to do your work, Lord, in us, Lord. And your work is love. So, Lord, lastly, I pray that love abounds in this church. That love is raised up. That we don't get too much in the theology, and we don't get too much in the knowledge, Lord, and we don't get too much into what this says and what that says, and being intelligent and being smart and being eloquent, Lord. But the focal point will be your love. Heavenly Father, love. Let it abound. Pour it down like a cup of water, Lord. Pour it on each and every one of us, Lord. That we may be drenched in your love. And whoever touch us will become wet in your love, Lord. Lord, let every drop that hit us splash off and touch the person next to us, Lord.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we are a church of love. Let it rain down, Lord. Let it rain down. Rain down, Lord. Rain down your love. Each and every one of us, we're going to say, rain down your love. Rain down your love. Let it rain down, Lord. And if our spirits ain't right, Lord, correct it, Lord. Put us in the right place. If there is anything in any of these individuals, in this church, in this building that is not like you, Lord, I say remove it, Lord. Remove it, Lord. Put us in line. Put us in the right place, Lord. And rain down your love. Rain down your love, Heavenly Father. Rain down your love, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, you love your child. You love your children. Heavenly Father, you love Reverend Jesse. And in your love, touch his back, Lord. Have compassion for your child. Heavenly Father, you love Pastor Scott. Heavenly Father, strengthen his legs, for you will put a big burden on his back. Help him to carry it, Lord. Make it so that it's light as a feather, because he puts all of the weight on you, Lord. Heavenly Father, touch Pastor Bridges, Lord. Heavenly Father, rain down your love. You love your child, Lord. And you don't want us in and out of the sick bed. You are not a God of the sick. You are not a God of the dead, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, rain down your love so that she will feel alive and she will have life and life more abundantly. Heavenly Father, rain down your love on Mother Scott, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, elevate her. Teach her the word so that she can share it with us, Lord. Yes, young people are supposed to go to our elders for wisdom, Lord. So first, Lord, let's pray wisdom on Mother Scott. Heavenly Father, pray, rain down your love and wisdom on Mother Scott. And every couple in here, and Omar and Courtney, Lord, bless them mightily, Lord. Rain down your love. And let it be like a reciprocal, Lord, that your love touches her and that it splashes off on him, and that your love touches him and that it splashes down on her. And let them never feel alone, Lord. Let them feel unloved, Lord. Let it rain down. Heavenly Father, I pray for the Seals, Mother Seals and Sister Seals, Lord. Lord, they come together as a team. Heavenly Father, you talked about the power of the three-strand rope. Each and every one of us are a rope that's entwined to each other so we cannot break, Lord. Not with you as the glue, Lord. Heavenly Father, strengthen their legs and strengthen their health. Give clean air to her lungs, Lord. Give clean air to her lungs, Lord. Heavenly Father, this asthma is not of you, Lord. It is not of you. We must go through things, Lord. We must go through things like Job did. It doesn't have anything to do with right or wrong, Heavenly Father. But sometimes things come upon us. But Lord, you set foot on this earth to bring victory. You came through on this earth to bring healing, Lord. You came through on this earth to touch those that are afflicted. And Heavenly Father, I pray that you do, that you confirm your word, that you confirm your word, that if we lay hands, Lord, that you will bring healing, Lord. And I call you on your promise, Lord, that you may be holy, that you may hold to your word, because you are not like men that you shall lie. Heavenly Father, we call it healed. We call it done. By our faith, Lord, by our faith, it is done. By our faith, it is done, Lord. By our faith. Heavenly Father, if we don't have a clear mind, if we don't have a clear conscience, we don't have a clear spirit, Lord, let us confront the things that brings cloudiness. Let us confront the things that confuse us, Lord, because we are to be free. And freedom and free indeed, Lord. In Jesus' holy name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. I promise you, I didn't mean to pray that long. But I had to say what the Lord had on my heart.
Yes.
Yes. You know what? Before we go into the word, Mother Sills, you stay right there. We need to, the elders need to pray for her.
Yeah. Come on. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. All that is done. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We love you. We thank you, Father. We are Father God. Lord, we come against the worst of the enemies right now, oh Father God. For too long, oh Father God, and for too hard, oh God. You've been fighting, oh Father God. Lord, you've given this lovely saint a spirit of beauty, a spirit of care, a spirit of generosity, and the enemy seeks to even take her breath away, oh God. And I rebuke him right now in the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
I rebuke that sickness right now in the name of the Lord, oh God. I just curse it at its root, that it shall shrivel up, oh Father God. We're asking for new life, new breath. And furthermore, the spirit is called the Ruach, and it's called the inbreathing. Because when he blessed Adam with life, oh God, the word of God says he breathed his life into him, and Adam became a living soul. So your breath is being attacked because your spirit is being attacked. And I come against those words that I was spoken against you. I come against those thoughts. I come against those deeds. I come against everything that's wrong. I come against every situation that you were in. Set upon you to take your breath away, oh Father God. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. And the righteous rush in and they are saved, oh Father God. Lord, as I squeeze this hand, oh Father God, let the blood flow properly, oh Father. As I squeeze this hand, oh Father God, let your goodness rain down upon the Lord. As I squeeze this hand, oh Father God, that every good thing that is due that is being held up in the name of Jesus be loosed right now, oh Father God. I don't know why she's on the envelopes, but bless the envelopes, oh Father God.
Bless you.
Turn around within the envelopes in a special way. End these days of suffering and bring them with joy, oh Father God. Lord, she's blessed generations and grows so many children, Lord. She's not going to be stopped. She shall have the victory. Thank you for the victory. Praise you for the victory. Magnify for the blessing. Bless you up for the financial blessing in the name of Jesus, oh Father God. And that when she returns home, things shall be different. Things shall be changed, oh Father God. Decisions shall be made, oh Father God. Things have to go sometimes, you properly. Thank sometimes you clean out some things that may take our breath away, oh God. Bless her. Do what has to be done in her life. Lord, we thank you, we love you, we adore you. In your own name we say,
amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
We're not looking to no science or any medical advancement. Our hope coming from the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me hear a praise in the name of any house of Job. Let me hear a show. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah is the highest praise. Raise it up. Raise it up. Hallelujah. 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 We thank you, Lord, for touching the health of Sister, Pastor Bridges and Reverend Jesse, and we thank you for the healing of Mother Sills, Lord. We thank you as if it's done. It is finished. It is done.
Yes. I mean, somehow while trying to do right, mess things up along the way, we disappoint others, we disappoint ourselves. But it's not beautiful.
People down, but we get up.
Hallelujah.
We fall down,
yes,
but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. Oh yes. For a saint is just a sinner who fell down.
But I don't know how many of y'all, but I fell down this week.
God.
But I got up and I'm here right now.
Yes.
But we get up, we fall down.
We fall down.
We get up, we fall down.
Just
we get up,
rise back.
Sometimes when you're down, you think about staying there. But we're here right now, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you can't rise to your feet,
get back up.
Show the enemy he's not gonna keep you down.
Get back up again.
Get back up again.
Get back up again. For a saint is just a sinner who fell.
Hallelujah. Look at Mother Seals standing up. Hallelujah. 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 Instant healing. Yes.
Get back up again.
Get back up.
Get back up again.
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 For a saint is just a sinner who fell.
You're the saint that they're talking about on this song. You can get back up. Hallelujah.
You can get back up again.
You can get back up again.
Get back up again.
You can get back up again.
You can get back up again.
Get back up again.
For a saint is just a sinner who fell.
Get back up again.
You can get back up again.
I don't
know about you, but the enemy tried to steal my joy. You put me through this week. But we're here together today. And we're going to get back up again.
The saint is just a sinner who fell down.
Yes, Lord. This song has been a blessing to me. I've been saying it in my mind all week because I've been through some things. I've suffered. I've suffered. I've been scared. I've been attacked. I've been pushed side to side, but guess what? I got back up. I don't want my strength. His strength. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Mother Scott.
So good.
I truly believe that I could do it on my own.
Yes. But then all that I found
at the end of the road, that concept for me was all wrong. I love this song.
I found a Savior
who turned me around and put Jesus' love on me. And I will trust in Him.
Here's what
day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
How about this is the day that the Lord has made?
Yes.
Not yesterday.
Yes.
Not tomorrow. This is the day. Yeah, let the people of God say, let the Lord evaporate. God.
Yes.
God speaks to you personally,
yes,
and calls you friend.
Yes.
It says it was accounted to him for righteousness.
Yes.
He was called the friend of God.
Yes.
I thank God that he offers you this praise.
Only believe.
come to set us free. Say hallelujah like free people. Hallelujah!
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 We're going to do it one more time. We're going to break the chains. We're going to break what binds us. I want to see these walls shake. I want to hear hallelujah! Hallelujah! To abide in the praises of his people. Hallelujah. If you want the Lord to manifest and show himself in this place, one more time, let me hear you say, hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That was a praise right there. It ain't gonna stop. We're not going to stop. We're going to keep this up.
Hallelujah.
We don't have to say hallelujah when I'm off to praise the Lord.
Yes,
keep that praise in your heart.
Yes.
No matter what goes on today,
yes,
the preacher is going to preach a word straight from God, and it's going to put it, let it be set on top of your praise.
Yes.
Because that sets the atmosphere for you to receive what the preacher has for you.
Yes.
Your praise set the atmosphere.
Yes.
Not the music, not anything outside. It's your praise.
Yes.
Your praise individually. Each and every one of you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We're going to go right into testimony service. And before I call anybody, since I'm up here first, I got a testimony.
All right.
This week was a good week. It's always a good week, whether I'm going through or not.
Yes.
But I went through this week.
Yes.
Someone who I love got into a big fight.
Jesus.
A big fight.
Jesus.
And I don't know whether that relationship will ever be mended.
My God.
Heavenly Father, but I know that he's clearing things up in my life.
Thank
and
you.
I have to let some people go.
Amen.
And I was wrong as well as the other person. And the thing is that God is teaching me.
Yes.
He's molding me.
Yes.
And Heavenly Father, yesterday I didn't even feel like getting out of bed.
Jesus.
Didn't feel like getting out of bed. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about?
Jesus.
You go through something so devastating.